Hello everyone, welcome to one more video of Special Biotonic, a channel to make biology subject easy. Today we'll talk about female reproductive system. Students, this system consists of a pair of ovaries, a pair of oviduct, uterus, vagina and vulva. Mammary glands are also part of this system. Let us understand all parts of this system in detail so that we can face any question coming from this topic. So watch the video till the end. Here, the primary sex organs are ovaries, as they produce female gamete, that is ova. These ovaries are present in the abdominal cavity near the kidneys. It is 2 to 4 cm in length. Ovaries are attached to abdominal wall by the ligaments to keep them in position. Ovarian ligament attaches ovaries to the uterus. They produce female gamete. They also produce the various hormones such as estrogen, progesterone, relaxin, etc. The next part of the female system is fallopian tube, which is also called as oviduct. It is a pair of muscular ducts lying horizontally over the peritoneal cavity. The proximal part of the tube lies close to the ovary, whereas the distal part is attached to the uterus. This tube is around 10 to 12 cm in length, and internally it is lined by ciliated epithelial cells. This fallopian tube is further divided into ampulla, isthmus and infundibulum. Infundibulum is a proximal part of the tube with an opening ostium. This opening is surrounded by finger-like processes called fimbri. The female gamete released by the ovary enters into the fallopian tube through this ostium. The middle part of the fallopian tube is ampulla. Fertilization occurs usually in this region. Isthmus is a distal part of the fallopian tube. It is connected to the uterus. Fallopian tube leads to the uterus. Now, uterus is a hollow muscular pear-shaped organ present above and behind the urinary bladder. It is commonly called as womb. It is 7.5 cm in length and 5 cm in breadth. It is further divided into fundus, body and cervix. Fundus is the upper dome-shaped part. Normally, fertilized zygote gets attached to this region. The broader part of the uterus is body. It gradually tapers downward. The body of the uterus leads to cervix. The cervix is a narrow part with a length of around 2.5 cm. Its one opening is towards the body of the uterus, whereas the other opening is towards the vagina. Histologically, uterus is made up of three layers: perimetrium, endometrium, and myometrium. Students, here peri means surrounding, myo means muscles, and endo means inside. So the outermost covering of the uterus is perimetrium. The middle muscular layer, that is made up of smooth muscles, is myometrium, and the innermost layer is endometrium. The endometrium is made up of stratified epithelial cells. Students, this stratified epithelial tissue is also found in the epidermis of skin, the inner lining of vagina and rectum. Please make a note of this. The thickness of endometrium changes as per the phases of menstrual cycle. It is richly supplied with blood vessels and uterine glands. Cervical canal along with vagina forms birth canal. Next part is vagina. It is a tubular copulatory organ with a length of 7 to 9 cm. Its wall is made up of three layers, outermost adventitia, middle muscular layer, and innermost stratified epithelium. The vagina opens into the vestibule through vaginal opening. This opening is covered by mucous membrane called hymen. Vagina serves as a passage for delivery of the baby, for menstrual flow, and receives the penis during the copulation. Students, this is the structure of external genitalia of the female, which is called as vulva. It is made up of two large skin folds called labia majora. On the inner side, it shows labia minora. Labia minora anteriorly fuses to form prepuce, whereas posteriorly it fuses to form forchet. Below the prepuce, there is an erectile structure called clitoris. It is made up of a pair of erectile tissues called corpora cavernosa. This clitoris is homologous to penis of male. Vulva encloses median vertical depression called vestibule. It encloses vaginal opening and urethral opening. Accessory glands are vestibular glands or Bartholin's gland. These are pair of glands which are homologous to bulbourethral gland or Cowper's gland of male. This is a commonly asked question in all competitive exams. So, which is a homologous organ of accessory gland or vestibular gland in male? So, the answer is bulbourethral gland or Cowper's gland. These glands open into vestibule and their secretion lubricate vagina during copulation. This is a sectional view of female reproductive system. Here, we can see uterus located above and behind the urinary bladder. This uterus leads to cervix and vagina. The vulva shows labia majora, labia minora. It also encloses vestibule, enclosing urethral as well as the vaginal opening. The anterior part of the vulva also shows clitoris. Students, in females, urinary system is separate from reproductive system. If you recall my previous video, we talked about the male system showing the urethra, common passage for urine as well as semen. So in male, it is called as urinogenital system, whereas in female, the both systems are separate. Please make a note of this. Many terms are also associated with this system, that is oophorectomy, which means removal of ovaries. Hysterectomy refers to the removal of uterus. Tubectomy is cutting the fallopian tube and joining its loose ends. Colpectomy is the removal of the vagina. So students, I hope you are clear with all the parts of female reproductive system. At the end, I request you all to like my channel, share it, and subscribe it. Stay home, stay safe. I'll see you in the next video. Thank you.